Oh no. I don't want to do it like this. I don't want to use the keyboard. Why? Fine. I guess I'll do that because clearly everything wants to die. Right. How do I even begin to explain? All right, last episode, my voice was completely different. I have not practiced anything since anything happened. There's frame rate shit. Oh my god, I'm going to already start freaking the fuck out because of how this is gonna work. How do I explain this? So, since the last episode, right? The great last episode. A lot of stuff happened. First of all, I got the new OS. And the new OS is good. My computer no longer randomly, crashes. That hasn't done that in a long time, I just realized. And I used to do that all the time, so that's good. However, what that also means, right, is, Jesus. Oh! What that also means, right, is, so the first OS that came out, cause let's be fair, we are now two separate OSs later, and the first OS that came out, it wouldn't play the emulator at all. So the emulator was just dead. And that's bad, because I need the emulator to work too. Record these videos. That I don't have a timer for. Because I'm fucking stupid beyond a shadow of a doubt. So. Right? What happened? First OS just shat the bed. Wouldn't run this program at all. You tried to open it, and it was just like, I don't know what you're trying to make me do, but I don't like it, and I don't want to do it. And I was just like, I understand what you mean, whatever, it's cool, it's fine, we'll figure this out later. I never figured it out later, because I didn't want to just download, I'm going to move the microphone, by the way, you move the laptop closer. I didn't want to just get a new emulator because the problem was, what if that emulator didn't work, right? What if the saves were corrupted in between moving files from one emulator to another? And let's be fair, knowing my life, that's probably what would have happened. So what I did do was I became patient. And I hoped. And I don't want to say pray, but you know what I mean. I begged the deities that the next OS like emulators better. And this one does. To a point. The problem is that while this new OS, El Capitan, does give me nice, happy times and allows me to actually use everything, what it does not do is it does not allow me to have volume. In order for this emulator to now work on the new OS, I have had to forfeit full screen mode, which, let's be fair, I didn't even have it to begin with, and I had to give up the entire idea of sound, which will now make this playthrough even harder, because I just remembered that the final boss has audio cues, and I no longer have those audio cues. I now have to, when he tries to use his rush attack, going to have to use some very, very good visual cues. So, there's that. It's bad. It can be better. But whatever. This is the life we live. As a new challenger, we press up. Not the new challenger. Wow, it has been a long time since I've even used that phrase. But as somebody who used to be the new challenger, hell, I was probably the new challenger when this series was fucking going on. And as somebody who still challenges games, and that's the whole point of this channel, and now that I've started Twitch streaming, I should probably Twitch stream channels for now, Twitch some things for now on. You know what I mean? The point being, things have gotten a little bit more interesting. To say the least. Hell, I don't have these audio cues. Just right. Where are you? There you are. Cool. Get me there. Get frozen, of course I will. Oh god. And that's pretty much it. Just this idea of I have no fucking control over the volume, I have no fucking control over the video size, so now the entire thing is super tiny, and oh my god, I forgot about this guy. Holy shit, get me the fuck out of here, please. I'm gonna die. My butt is about to be. Probably know this could be just be the epilogue video that explains why this challenge is forever dead. I hope not. But it could possibly be. I don't know. I had to delete 13.1. That's what I was calling the original episode 13. Because, like, the old voice, and it was just me leveling up and talking about it. I don't even know what the fuck I was talking about because I didn't listen to it all the way, and I don't care. Point being, you know, this is what we now have. This is what happens if I get to do Game Boy Advance games from now on. I get to, I kid you not, edit in all of the audio. So in the future, when this episode comes out, if you're watching this episode and it has music in it, all the music was put in by me manually. And if I actually decide to put in the whip sound effects, those will also be manually put in by me. Isn't that great? It's gonna be so much fun. So this is what happens now. This is how this works. This is how the truest Castlevania happens. Castlevania gave kind of a life to Dark Souls, and now it has brought me back. And I will go insane with it. So what else is new? Well, today I saw Arrival. I'm thinking it came out this weekend. I'm not entirely sure. Today is Monday. Time stamping this, by the way. You're not supposed to do that, but I break all the rules because I don't give a fuck about rules. And, yeah, that's a... Arrival's a good movie. I'm so happy that it didn't take the... It didn't do what I thought it was gonna do. I was scared that at some point... I'm gonna spoil this right here. Because this isn't a spoiler to the plot, it's a spoiler to what I don't like in modern movies. In a lot of modern games. Ironic, because I'm playing Castlevania and I'm complaining about this next thing. Does everything have to be violent? That's my official stance on the movie. Is it so good with only, like, future makes sense that somebody did a thing. So in the movie, there's like no violence, okay? And it's awesome because it proves you can fucking film a movie like this and not go the violent route. You can do it. It's actually possible. And it's awesome. And the movie is good while not going the violent route. Like, I was so scared that I was gonna do the thing and everybody was gonna try to kill everybody else and yada, blah, blah. Where's my... No, hold on. Why is it delete? Fine, whatever. That's my fucking button for the fucking map. Whatever. I need to find the next save point. I just want to find a save point that's closer to the boss. It's a bit of a hike, especially if I don't have any health. It's kind of bad for me. Ah, shit. Don't do it. But no, it's good. Arrival's a very good movie, and you should definitely see it. Is that it? Yes, maybe. At the very least, this is a door. It will bring me to a thing. Did not bring me to a save point. It makes me a little upset. Where does this go? Yep, I should have been worried. Oh, of course. Why am I not surprised? It was a fucking useless thing. That I will never use. Goddamn. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. I will escape. I win. Awesome. How good I am at this game. Okay. So, yeah. Go see Arrival. I have my mail scripting midterm. Because mail scripting. And I got a fucking thingamajigger for a score, a dick butt. I got a 100. Which honestly, in a way, pisses me off because a teacher promised us that we would get PDFs with like notes about what he thought of our midterms. And then it's just like, oh no, you didn't need, I didn't give you a PDF because you did so good. And just like, but I wanted to see what your notes are. I wanted to know what you thought. Please, sir, give me the notes. Why can I not have notes? Because I did this really cool thing. I did this really, really interesting thing. And I was like so excited when I did it because I was just like, ah! Ah! I was like a goofy goober. What I did was we had to make a W out of cubes, and it had to be 25 cubes. Oh god, it had to be a 25 cubes high. So what that means is it took like 98 cubes or something. That's 25 cubes. Height-wise. Right? Heights. Those are a thing. Height and width and dimension and sound and all that. TARDIS. I'm going nuts. Sorry. Let me continue. So what I did was I pretty much instantly, like the first thing, oh, they also had to be colored different colors, the randomly generated colors. So 98 or whatever cubes, because 25 height, W. 25 cubes high, W made out of cubes. And I had to also, oh, I love you. It also had to, every single cube had to have a different color on it. So 98 cubes, 98 colors. So what I did was I first made an integer. And it was called height. Now, if you don't know how coding works, this is pretty much how coding works. You can set integers. Integers are numbers that will be stored, and now all you have to do is type a keyword, and that number will forever appear, according to the computer's brain, whenever that keyword is typed. So let's say you just choose the letter I, and you say, letter I equals 5. Every time you type the letter I, well, $I. But every time you type $I, the computer instantly just goes, yo, this bitch wants the number 5 here. And why is that important? Because Integers are used for interchanging, for things that are constantly changing. Now, what I mean by that is, right, let's say today your boss wants a thing and wants 10 things made. So you make $9, I equals 10. And then these 10 things are affected. Like, let's say I want 10 things that are randomly generated, are animated, and are different colors. So you set up $i as 10. And then you just go, okay, $i Lamberts makes, or colors, makes 10 colors. $i shapes makes 10 shapes. Yeah, yada, blah, blah. But let's say tomorrow he decided, well, actually, now I want 15. Well, rather than go through the code and change every single 10 to a 15, you just go through that one single line that says $i equals 10. You change that 0 to a 5, and the computer will instantly read it and place 15 everywhere else. So what I did, and I think this is brilliant, I'm honestly super proud of myself for doing this. I figured out the formula that is needed that will determine how many cubes will be made for a height of x cubes, a w made out of cubes. For, let's say the height is 2, then the amount of cubes needed will be 5. The number is, it's a W made of cubes that are 3 cubes high. Then the amount needed is 9. So how do you do that? It is X. It is 4 multiplied by, in parentheses, X minus 1. Close parentheses, plus 1. So, no matter what number you decide, let's say I want 10 cubes. 10 minus 1 is, I want a W made out of 10 cubes, that is 10 cubes high. So 10 minus 1 is 9, times 4 is 36, plus 1 is 37. A W made out of cubes, and it's 10 cubes high, will take 37 cubes to make. So I did that. I made that number into an integer, and then I made the colors directly beforehand. And I thought that was pretty interesting, just to make the colors instantly beforehand. And then rather than have a loop that made the blocks, move the blocks, make the color and put the color on the block, it was just like, make block, move block, put color on block. That's already created. That was it. And I probably saved like 5 lines or 6 lines by putting one in. You were with Dracula in the hall. That was weird. I am Camilla. I beckoned Dracula forth. Why do you want his return? To turn this world into a living hell? But isn't this world hellish already? People are intrigued by darkness and covet chaos and power. They're dirty, self-centered mongrels. I simply wish the world to properly reflect this image. You're delusional! Oh, shit. Oh, I thought that was a boss fight. If only you two would embrace the darkness in your soul, then a new world would unfold before you. Shut up. The one who was with you. He was more honest with himself. Even my master approves of him. What? What have you done with you? So, this is Camilla. I remember nothing about her. I don't remember these fucking orbs of death. Oh my god, I remember this. So this is what I remember. She has that laser. If you crouch the laser, it's fine, it's great, it's good. That's it. That's all you have to do. Holy shit, that fucking lightning hurts. Oh, fuck, that hurt. Oh, fuck, that also hurts. Oh my god. I don't know what I'm doing. Can I just destroy the purple orbs? Is that a thing I can do? It's not a thing I can do. It's not a thing I can do! Shit. Great. Ah, well, at least I made it to the boss. Which is good, because that means there was more fucking shit in this episode than I thought there was gonna be. I should have leveled up once. Or twice. What the fuck was that? Oh, is that the furnace? Right. Awesome. Let me do this, please. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you and your evil hands. The other thing, and that's kind of important, it needs to be talked about, is, first of all, the Twitch. Since last episode the Twitch came out, that's kind of important because I'm hopefully going to be using that more often once I do the other thing, which is I will be moving in March. Not these idiots that I live with. No, I'm going to be living with a friend. It's going to be good, it's going to be fun. This will be out in the middle of goddamn nowhere, but at this point, I mean, whatever. Honestly, I think, and this is coming from a trans woman, Nebraska won't be that bad. I mean, my friend is very open-minded. He assures me that everybody in the neighborhood that he lives by is very open-minded. So, I just want to check the purple. Perfect. So I don't have to worry. Okay. That's not going to go well if I can get rid of those purple blobs. Find out how much health this bitch has, because I have no fucking clue. And also, stop doing that! Which would be great. That's pretty much the one thing I'm scared of, and should be scared of. So what I'm thinking is I get like two hits, alright? Or one. Or none. Or I could try getting behind her directly. Or that. Do shit like this. This is not gonna work. Why are you not doing anything? You please, please fucking. Please. This might be like the best time to hit her, is after she does that. Gah! These motherfucking Binding of Isaac combing orbs, I swear. Oh, is that why he chose purple for the humming orbs? Did he base it off of this? But, yeah. So, I trust my friend with... I mean, I shouldn't, but I do. I just wanna fucking hit you. There. So that's pretty much what's happening. Now nobody actually knows I'm moving except for some friends. Like, family doesn't know. Family knows nothing. Which is hilarious because I know nobody in the family watches this, so I don't have to fucking worry. I mean, I know Madre, right? She knows channel name. She's happy I found a name that... When she found out I was the Let's Play Princess now, it was just like, well, it fits more with, like, who you are, but I don't like the name, but it makes more sense. And she's like, how can you hate it and also say it makes more sense? How do you do this? Why do you do this? I almost had it too. That would have been cool. Ah, fuck, man, if I could get that one. That one I got. Well, that one I got. Ah, shit. Oh. Okay, nice success. Now, like I said, I have no idea how much health she has, so far all I know. And I'm probably, right, probably not gonna do that thing where I used to put the, I mean, I might. It won't look as cool because of the new iMovie. Because, oh yeah, iMovie also changed since the last episode. It sucks. Like, it heavily sucks. It's horrible now. So there's that. Right. Fantastic. But, yeah, they force, transitions on you. Unless you're like, yeah. Unless you, are putting it in a certain corner. It's just like specific areas are now specific transitions. Like if you're in the bottom right corner putting text in, you the bottom right corner now will always be a fucking fade in, fade out transition text. And it's just like, no, I just want it to be there. And iMovie's just like, but no, bottom right equals over. Equals fade out text. And it's just like, but I don't want fade out text. I want just normal fucking magically appears, fucking magically leaves text. And it's just like, well, fuck you too. That's its response. It's great. No, not that Apple was also getting rid of the headphone jack and everything. So there's that. There's also that. I have 1 minute. I get to try again. So I have to be super, super patient with this boss, it seems. That is the problem. I have to do this boss super slow to make sure that I can get rid of these purple orbs and not get hit by lightning, which I'm about to. Or not. Not sure. I'm not even gonna get hit by that. Is also fucking motherfucker. Oh god. Come back down. Yes. Cool. Okay. You turn really fast. Did you know that? Oh god. You wouldn't let me turn. It's not letting me do half the shit I wanted to do. This is not gonna go well. Nope, I'm dead. Just kill it. Please. Or not. Now, for those of you new to this series, right? This is a naked run. I should probably have stated that since this might be people's first episode of this shit. So goodbye to Let's Challenge Circle of the Moon, the naked run, which means, I'm gonna quickly show off what that means. Clearly you saw me not use magic. If you're new to this game, there's a fucking magic system. I didn't use it. I have no armor on either. You get the whip, the jump, and the specific movement things that they give you because this is a fucking Metroidvania game. So pretty much I am playing this like it is a original Castlevania game. Except I'm also not using sub-weapons because you didn't see me do shit like this. Also doesn't help I have the knife because the knife is bad. However, in the future I might be re-looking at this game. Maybe. I have had thoughts about this game, about where to go, what to do, yada yada blah blah. My thought process is I will do this game four or five more times in the far off future, depending on certain things. Pretty much, once you beat this game, there's a magician mode, and then once you beat magician mode, you get another mode, and yada yada blah blah. One mode is pretty much sub weapons are overpowered, the whip is bullshit and crappy. One is you get all the magic cards early. Damage is absolutely dreadful, but your magic attack is very powerful. So my thought process is... thought I heard the mouse. My thought process is magician run, where if I am not attacking with magic, I am not attacking, period. I thought shooter mode challenge run, which is no whip. You're just allowed to use sub-weapons. No magic and no whip. That does mean I'm going to be using the magic dagger, which is a special shooter mode only sub-weapon, which I've never used before. But I am told if you get a dagger and you grab another dagger, you will get the magic dagger, which has a homing ability. So pretty much boss battles are just going to be me farming hearts and then upping the shit out of them. But that's pretty much it. That's my story. That's what's been going on since the big gap between episodes. And yeah, I will see you all next time. I also joined CGN. I have a Twitter. I fucking hate Twitter. I have a Facebook page. Everything is just Let's Play Princess. There are links in the YouTube channel's thingy-ma-jigger, so you can just check. But honestly, subscribe here. Maybe follow on Twitch. I Twitch every like Tuesday night or Wednesday night, depending on when, if I'm streaming that week at all. And yeah. I will see you all next time.